Yeah.
That's what's on the track. The track team. And the vape.
So you can take some of the floors, yes, some of the floors. I took my money, put some kind of church into
it. And sweep it.
My teacher, because she's been working shows all around the world, and all the time, you know, whatever.
And if you're one of the
people who shows to do this work, I'm like, no, I got to get some in my memory. So that became my motivation, and I had a
let's make sure no one dies.
I did everything myself. I was starting from scratch. I had a teacher school that I knew. Just hope. I'm a talk. She was like, yeah. He said nothing. Just did it. You know,
not every person.
Right now, then, in life, it's like,
it's meant to two
chaos.
But if you don't have the resources, and you can understand also, we should understand the
mission. Because it can inspire you. We start to try ideas.
Folks, we're going to be coming right back to sit down. We don't want to keep you here too late. We're trying to wrap up before 7 p.m. Give you back some of your time. I know some folks didn't head out.
With the drugs coming into the black community. He wrote an article, became a book, and it became a movie. He was found. How many of y'all seen the movie? Any of y'all seen the movie? They found him dead in the hotel with two bullets to the back of his head. They said it was a suicide. Okay. So he shot himself in the back of the head one time and it didn't work, so he did it again. Right? So we know that the Dark Alliance is real and that this has been the history of drugs being brought, particularly in the black community. And the drugs was never a problem until the pharmaceutical companies got greedy and now the opioids reached out into white communities and it became a big problem when in suburbia, young white boys and girls, men and women, right, began to be affected by the opioids. Then it became a crisis. Then it became a lot of, we gotta do something about this. We gotta have programs. We gotta support drug treatment, rehab centers, right? And that's good. That's a great thing. Why is fentanyl so easily available in the black community? It's just a question. Now, it's a problem that's affecting all of us. But the solution is gonna require all of us working together.
The next person I'm bringing up to speak is someone who I came across through my travels of Achieve Greatness. And he was someone who was incarcerated for 20 years. He was someone who was actually selling right here in Boston. He was someone who, when he was incarcerated, lost his mother and his youngest brother to fentanyl poisoning. He has not only turned his life around, he is now working with youth, but I consider him to be a partner with me because this is exactly what Achieve Greatness is about. I'm not looking at your color. To me, you're a human being. And whatever we can do together is what we need to do because that's the human part of all of this. So I want to bring up Devon, and he's going to tell his story.
Peace. I know I don't have that much time, and honestly, I don't have enough time anyway to tell you my whole story. I want to say a few things up here. Before I say anything, I would not be standing here today if it wasn't for the grace of God.
That's right.
As I understand him to be. There's an individual by the name of Allah Fu Quan. The world will know his name. If I have to do it by myself, which I know I won't have to, I will. It's only through his grace that I'm standing here today because he looked me in my eyes 18 years ago in a prison library and said, I love you, black man. Peace. I need y'all to help me count real quick, please. Count to 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That's how many years I spent in prison, like Miss Paula said. I spent 20 years in prison justly. I'm responsible for taking a young man's life on July 19th of the year 2000 at 12:37 p.m. I shot this man twice. Once in the chest and once in the stomach. As a result, he died. When this man fell to the ground in slow motion, I watched his body fall and I laughed. I turned to about 15 of our peers And I said, look what just happened. I laughed again and I ran away. If that's not mental illness, then what is? Yes. But how did I get like that? I like to say I was made in America.